This week, a total solar eclipse will pass over North America, causing substantial drops in solar power output. The greatest impacts will be in the Electric Reliability Council of Texas and PJM interconnection power markets. Eckert solar production expected to dip to 3 gigawatts during the eclipse, lower than the usual 18 gigawatts on a clear day in April. U.S. steelmaker Nucor will issue its first steel price update on Monday through its new weekly consumer spot price report. This signals a new approach for steel price communications in the U.S. at a time when domestic hot rolled coil prices are recovering from a two-month decline. With import demand continues to pressure the America's container freight market, even after the collapse of the Francis Scott Key Bridge on March 26 closed the port in Baltimore. Sources say other East Coast ports can absorb the flow of container traffic and are unlikely to be affected. In agriculture, U.S. soybeans are facing competition from Brazil's abundant supply and reduced intake from China, the world's largest soybean importer. The U.S. will only regain competitiveness once its harvest begins in early fall. U.S. corn is also struggling to compete against Black Sea and Argentinian products, but exports from the U.S. are currently meeting market expectations. I'm Catherine Desen. Thank you for kicking off your Monday with S&P Global Commodity Insights.